What is going on, my friends, and welcome back to another video here on the channel. Well, I want to give you a quick update on what we're seeing from Bitcoin because it is a little bit concerning and I just want you to at least be aware of it. And so with that said, let's not waste any more time at all and let's get straight into the video. Now guys, don't forget, if you do use the Margex link down below to sign up and start trading, you're going to get access to their newly announced $500,000 cashback airdrop, and you're going to get again up to $10,000 in bonuses when you do sign up with the link down below. Remember, to sign up, you don't need to KYC, meaning you don't need to tell them who you are. You don't need to use a VPN. You can just sign up and start trading within a few minutes. And again, get access up to $10,000 in bonuses, $500,000 cashback airdrop. Take advantage of that. Again, the link is in the description below. This is where I do all of my trading on up to 100x leverage, and you can too. Now, looking at Bitcoin today, what we're going to be focusing in on is what is happening on the shorter term timeframes with its price, okay? Because it's a little bit concerning. Now, it doesn't mean that for sure we're going to see this thing pull back or that we're going to see another crash on the way, but I am being cautious right now. Okay, I am being cautious right now. Now, what we can see is that Bitcoin's price has recovered quite decently over this weekend. Of course, putting in lows around 52,500, all the way back up to about 55,500, putting in a nice little $3,000 relief rally there. But what we are seeing from the 4-hour charts, especially on the RSI at this exact moment, is giving me a cause for concern that this might not hold and we may see some type of pullback. Maybe it's towards either try to set a double bottom or maybe literally just continue this move to the downside. Now, what this is the fact that we are already starting to see this 4-hour RSI surpass this 50% threshold already, even though its price is nowhere near, not even remotely close to the highs that we put in here. As you can see here, we put in this high around 59.8, we put in this high around 59.6. In the same time, we put in a high around 53% here and around 49% here. And at this exact moment, we're still setting a massive lower high here on the price, but we're trying to already set a higher high here on the RSI. What that means is that as this price is starting to go upwards, its RSI or the momentum is moving much faster. And oftentimes when this happens, a pullback towards the downside or just a correction from this is extremely likely. Now, a few things that you can look at to kind of get a gauge of if this is a possibility or if this is something that is moving too quickly is the Bollinger Bands. You look at something like your Bollinger Bands, you can already see we're almost to the top side of our 4-hour Bollinger Band envelope already, meaning we're already nearly 2 standard deviations away from this 20 simple moving average, which historically is when you will see pullbacks, as you can see here. And so because of that, I am just a little bit concerned. Now, I did over on my second channel earlier this morning, also I tend to forget to mention on this channel, go check that out if you like. We do a lot of broad market stuff talking about what's happening from a fundamental perspective, but I talked about the fact that we are seeing 24-hour liquidations to the downside picking up a lot, and oftentimes when this happens, some type of cool down or pullback does happen. And so when you pair what we're seeing here on the 4-hour charts to what we are seeing here on the liquidation map, I am a little bit concerned that we might see this price pull back to what could be as low as, you know, 53, if not the bottom side of 50, you know, 53,500 again. So I am just being cautious. Now, I am still doing my daily dollar cost average throughout the month of September because I do think, and you know, history has shown, buying in the month of September is one of the best times that you can buy, especially during a halving year. So I am still doing my accumulation, but I am being very cautious about it just the next few days while we are seeing these things play out. And so of course, you know, I'm not trying to say that this market's for sure going to pull back. I'm not saying anything like that. Again, I'm just noticing it. It is something that's concerning me, and I always like to just share my thoughts with you guys. So let me know down in the comments below. Are you being cautious right now? Are you buying? Are you selling? Are you shorting? Are you holding? Remember, I try to respond to every single comment, so make sure that you do leave it down there. And while you are down there, don't forget, if you do want to knock out some trades on Bitcoin, you can use the link down there below to Margex and get you up to $10,000 in sign-up rewards and again, a $500,000 cashback airdrop. So check all that stuff out down below, and I can't wait to see you all in the next one. Peace out, everybody.